most difficult number.
I am not dumb, that's the problem. You're not supposed to stick your
fingers. Hey guys, welcome back to Cooking with My Dumb Friends. I'm Christian, of course, and this is my dad.
Jerome.
We're on location in North Carolina. I came here to visit him for his birthday, and we're going to teach you how to make French bread.
All right, awesome.
Okay, so it's pretty simple ingredients. There's not really a lot to it. French bread is just something that tastes amazing and really doesn't require you to put much in it to have that result. So what we have is bread flour. We're going to have some water. We've got kosher salt. You can use any kind of salt, but not like a coarse salt. You just want one that'll distribute evenly throughout the dough. And yeast. We got active dry. You can do the instant, but the instant you'll actually mix directly in with the flour. And this we're going to mix in with water beforehand.
So this is a local one? Yeah. So this is a Raylan wine locally. It's about 20 minutes from here. So North Carolina has really started growing wines in vineyards, which has been very interesting here. So we probably got about 50 vineyards now. They used to do sweet because they liked their sweet tea. But in the last 5 years, they decided to go with a more drier wine like in France. So now they've got Cabernet Sauvignon, Cabernet Franc, Syrahs. I mean, they've really been doing a lot of good wines here in North Carolina. So it's been very enjoyable to go to the vineyards.
There you go, there's some.
There you go.
Sweet.
No, it's dry.
Come on, Daddy. Don't you all love dad jokes? The first of 12 steps when you're making a yeast bread is scaling. So we're going to scale our ingredients first. I know a lot of baking recipes here in the United States use cups and all that kind of stuff, and teaspoons, but that's really not accurate. And that's why we have such inconsistent results when we're using somebody else's recipe. It's like, well, this didn't turn out like they made it. And that's because it's not very scientific. So weight measurements are actually the best way to go, and we're going to use grams today. So if you have a scale, that is awesome. If not, sorry, this is going to be a recipe you're going to have to convert and try to get similar results. But honestly, it is fully worth it to get a scale to get the kind of results that you do when you scale things out anyway. Cool. So we are doing 500 grams of...
So put the bowl on first.
You can zero it out.
Yeah. That's true. Okay, I'm done that again. All right.
See?
Well, you know, because I can turn it on when I put it on there.
That's all. And that works too. So there are two methods to tear out what you're measuring in. You can turn it on after you put the bowl on there. It's a heavy bowl.
And the reason you want that is that you can zero it out with the bowl on it. So when you do your measurements, the only thing you're measuring is the flour, not the bowl also.
Right. Accuracy.
Yes.
It matters. Wait. It's taking a minute to catch up. 366?
I know where I'm coming close to.
Okay,
whoa.
No, it's all right. 497.
See? Pretty close. Okay.
Wait.
I haven't put enough in there.
512. Yes.
Okay, we took a little out. No big deal. You're not wasting it.
I know. Okay, 500. We're at 500. There you go,
See,
Daddy.
That was difficult.
That was great. That was fantastic. You really killed it. Is the yeast.
So you need warm water?
No, not yet.
Oh, well, you need to warm it up, though.
We're just going to measure it first, Daddy. Okay. All right. You want 6.25 grams of yeast.
I'm going to need some more wine.
I'm going to need some, too.
Where's that now?
Did it just say six?
Okay, well, that's fine.
All right.
I need to put a whole packet in. That's interesting. Okay.
I know, but it's just proportions of this recipe.
I got you.
Okay, so then for the water, and we want to use warm water to be precise, but he doesn't have a thermometer, so we're going to seal it out. 105 degrees. You definitely don't want it to be anywhere near boiling. 105 is like a warm bath, like a really warm bath. 140 is where yeast dies, and we don't want to kill our yeast. I'm saying there's a reason why I'm trying to teach you what I know, and it's because I know stuff.
Oh, I like the thing you're doing the total water though, because I didn't even think about that. Because I used to put a little water there, then I put the water for the ingredient.
Yeah, it changes things.
I didn't think of the total water thing. That's got to do. I've had problems making French bread for a lot of years. So this is my birthday wish, to learn how to make French bread from my chef daughter.
Mm-hmm. Wishes do come true.
I know. Awesome.
Oh, snap, Daddy. Right on. All right, we'll cross our fingers with that. It's 105 degrees or very close. We use 6 1/4 grams of yeast. So we use 25 grams of water.
Yep. So that's easy. Put that on there. Mm-hmm. Turn it on.
And this one we can't take a spoon out. So you gotta go slow.
Oh, yeah. I get that. Okay, zero it out, right?
Yep, it's zero. So we're gonna put 25 in there.
Okay. So I'm gonna go so far.
Six. There we go. We're at 25. All right.
And so we got the rest of the water here.
So we want to mix it in.
Okay. That's pretty thick. I need to do less water, more water. That's interesting.
Okay. See, but you don't get the results you want.
I do not. That's why I haven't been able to make bread right. So, and then the water thing too. That's a good point. So I was putting too much water is what I was doing.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get that.
Last but not least, we have to weigh our salt. 8, 9, 10.
Alright, good. There you go.
10. Alright. So we're gonna put yeast in here. What's this little guy?
You don't need any butter or anything like that?
No butter.
No butter?
Nope. French bread's fat free.
Is it really? Well, it's not carbohydrate free though.
Well, no. Those are two very different things, Daddy.
Well, no, but it turns into sugar, which is fat.
Which sits in your body as fat if you don't use it.
Yes.
Yeah. All right. You want to add the flour?
Once you get done with that.
All right, Daddy. Okay. So we've got our dough. We cover it with a towel. We're gonna put it in there to rise for an hour.
For an hour?
For an hour. We proofed our dough for an hour and we're gonna pull it out and check it out. Nice. So that looks pretty good.
Nice and fluffy.
Very, very big. So what we want to do is, they say punch it down, but you actually shouldn't punch your bread. What you want to do is actually fold in each side. Burst a lot of the huge bubbles that we don't want in our dough. Pull it out. Next is scaling. So each baguette is 11 ounces of dough. You want to handle it as little as possible just to not overhandle your dough. Yeah, we got some bubbles, but
that's good.
Yeah,
it's good.
Ah, 11 ounces.
Dang,
girl. Isn't that nice?
That's impressive.
Pretty good.
All
right,
so
6 off of this. So, yeah, rounding the dough. You can round it in your hand, but you can also just round it on the bench. So then for French bread, we actually want to roll it out into an oval shape. Ooh. That's good.
No, go ahead. Dad, you gotta do it too. Hold the paper. It kind of sinks.
Mm-hmm. It's fluffy dough though, huh?
It's flipping good. It's very light.
Mm-hmm. You just pull this guy out because we want to elongate him some, but gently. We don't want to hurt him.
Yeah. How far do you want to go?
I don't know. How long do you want your baguette?
Well, the baguettes are pretty long. Mm-hmm. You think it goes that long?
I don't know. Well, we'll find out.
Not trying to tear it a little bit.
Yeah, don't tear it. So we're going to preheat our oven at 475. And while we're preheating it, we're going to put a pan in here because for crusty type breads like this, we want to introduce some steam in the first 5 to 10 minutes.
Well, now you fold them in, right?
So this is like our benching and the makeup and panning stage is combined pretty much. And so, yeah, so the next thing we'll do is, and that's just to release some of the CO2 and relax the dough a little more. So we'll roll it up into our baguettes now, but you want to do a really tight roll so you're not like making bubbles.
Now, you put that on a cookie pan?
Yeah, we'll put it on. We will put it on a cookie pan. I mean, you put it on a pizza baking stone. Those are great.
Oh, that's too long.
You gonna have to do a diagonal. Ooh, look who fits just right.
Yeah, but when it expands, it's gonna come off the edge.
It shouldn't get longer.
Okay.
It should just get... Okay. We're going to score these. Like, you know, you always see the little splits in the top of baguettes. And we have a razor blade. You can use a straight razor. If you got a super sharp knife, you can do that. But you don't want something that's dull because it'll just drag the dough along and just not really give you that clean cut.
So why are we doing this?
Just because that's traditional. But also, the slits help to prevent like cracking.
Yeah, so it helps the bread expand?
Without cracking.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay. And breaking.
Right, got it. Okay.
And our oven's almost preheated, so once it is, we're gonna throw this in there, and right away we're going to put ice cubes on that sheet pan that we have in there, and that'll produce the steam we want to give us the texture crust.
How many
that
ice cubes?
Desired. A handful. At 475 now, we're gonna toss it in the oven, and I'm gonna toss this ice on our tray. Bread first.
Take the ice later out.
We'll leave it in there for 5 to 10 minutes. We're gonna eyeball it, and then like basically once it's done with that first oven spring, where you know how like when you see the time lapse on breads baking, it's like whoo, you know, like that. That's the oven spring. So we're just going to eyeball it for 5 or 10 minutes, and then pull that out and let it bake dry for the rest of the 20 minutes. So another 10 minutes. So our bread's looking nice and brown, so we're gonna pull it out.
Oh, this one really good.
Get it. So it's hot. I wanna try some. So we're supposed to cool it. That's the next step. And then the final step is storage. So however you wanna store it.
No. Yeah, this guy.
Yeah, okay.
Your came out better than mine.
See how we did. Look at that.
Oh, man.
That looks great.
Oh, it smells good, too.
It smells good. All right. Mm-hmm.
Oh yeah. That's good.
We did it, huh?
We did it. Good job.
Yeah, okay, Daddy.
Oh yeah, that's great, man. Thank you. Great birthday gift.
Happy birthday, Daddy.
Oh, thank you. That's really good.
Alright, y'all. Well, we did it. We solved a mystery for Daddy on the French bread.
Yes. Happy birthday to me.
Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching this show. Please like it, share it, subscribe, because that's really awesome. And come back and see us when we do the next episode.